Welcome to Tattooed Madman, a professional wrestling who just escaped from the metal world. Take cover, it's PsYcHo.
Here at ringside, we have him from Three National Wrestling Magazines here for this front row card. Test of strength, and the Krusher's going to win that one. Earlier on, we had a chance to talk to Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff, who is taking a surprising amount of interest in this matchup. Says the North American Championship is something he's interested in. Even though he does have another title match, he said he would like to win two or three titles if he could. And Psycho with a good leg drop. He turned that whole situation around. Difficult moment for the Krusher because he realizes he has got to do something. Settle things down. He is no longer the champion. He didn't accept it graciously. He said Psycho Mike didn't deserve the title, but Psycho pinned him. Big body slam. Now remember, Krusher is heavier than Psycho Mike. And Mike is heading to the top rope. This is how crazy he is. He's never known for aerial tactics. Bounce away! Oh! Throw him right into the mat. And Psycho, and the Krusher for that matter, both hurting right now. The Krusher said he would not settle for just the title. He wants to cripple Psycho Mike because he was embarrassed last night. Look at this. Pressure now. Taking Mike all over the place. Batters him in the ring. Hung him right on that rope. A clothesline of sorts. There you see the photographer's getting a shot of Mike with that dubious haircut. And uh-oh, what is this? And a man he calls you a mo. Oh no. Oh my. And those huge thighs are feeling that one. Psycho Mike. Psycho Mike now to go walk around the ring.
Wonderful! Wonderful! Wonderful!
Oh, stretched out the hamstring that time. Krusher suddenly in a bad way. Oh, forearm shot to Psycho Mike, and there's where that weight advantage comes in handy. Bucky Barma, the referee, again, a little slow starting that count. Bucky's a little intimidated at this point in his career. A lot bigger than when he first started out as a referee. Unbelievable. Krusher now with a headlock, and what he's trying to do is wear out Mike with that weight. I mean, that is a big advantage, and don't kid yourself, folks. You don't want a guy being spunky, but you have got to be able to go with countermaneuvers when a guy has the kind of leverage that's glued behind that weight. Krusher may do things illegally, but he knows wrestling. Oh, there's a big bear. Couldn't get it on him. tried to get it on him. Mike partially blocked it, but still had those big old arms around him. He's having trouble getting out of it. He thought he had something going, but he didn't.
Come on, give him a thumb in the eye, Psycho!
Hey, Krusher, I want to get
him! Trying to use the eye gouge, but that didn't work. But Krusher drops the big elbow on the chest, and oh, you can see it really take its toll on Mike. Palermo now with the cover. Two used the ropes that time, still couldn't get the three count. Palermo. Trying to come up with a way to keep these two in order. That was a low shot. And Mike laughing about that one. Now Mike ready to send the ropes. Hang on, what a clothesline. Chance to finish him off. The elbow. Cover. No. Thought I had him that time. Didn't grab the legs.
Big fat piece of beef.
There goes for the headlock. Now that is about as a comfortable position to be in as anybody. But Krusher does have that weight advantage. One of the things that has made him so tough. Jack Reynolds, one of our hosts tonight, was talking earlier about the various ways you have to deal with these type of wrestlers. Big shoulder block that time by the Krusher. Krusher now. Wait a minute. Let him run out here. Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff, what's he doing here? Look out! Oh, he just gave a pile driver to Psycho Mike. The pile driver. Turn around. Wait a minute. Two.